Alright, I got it.
Already,
I got it now. I don't know why I took it.
This nigga, 3 touchdowns, 8 interceptions. Nah, I ain't playing against nobody. I'm just looking at my stats. Huh?
Open back in 2003, have a look at the link. Lincoln Financial Field, where 70,000 are rocking and ready to go in Philadelphia. The scene a few moments ago, here it is. It's unlike any other in sport. As both teams made their way out of the tunnel, these folks are fired up as their guys are ready to do battle between the Los Angeles Rams and the Philadelphia Eagles. 2 weeks have come and gone. It's off to week 3, and we're underway on EA Sports.
Come on, Rams, let's go!
To the 35 now as they come up.
Y'all got y'all game on YouTube or anything?
Here's the first carry for Ezekiel Elliott. And brought down, but not before reaching the 45-yard line. It's a Rams first down on a pickup of 10.
Well, I think that's what they're going to need to do here in the first half. You've got to take some pressure off of this young quarterback, and no better way to do it to establish the running game early.
Inside,
but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, this big defensive lineman will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
The last run good for 2. Here's 2nd and 8. Inside the 40, not quite to the 35. A good pickup, 17 yards, and also a Rams first down. Now look, that wasn't a huge game, but those are the types of carries I think they were missing in their loss last week. They couldn't get him going on the ground.
Did you get the same feeling I did during our meetings, that they kind of regretted that he didn't touch the
Absolutely.
Ball?
Absolutely.
You know, hey, he should have touched him more last week. They weren't going to make that same mistake, and they've taken care of that early.
So from Philadelphia territory now, here's a 1st and 10 at the 36.
Swing!
couple down inside the 35 to the 34.
Well, we saw him there trying to get it to the outside, trying to get to the perimeter, but not a whole lot of room there. But there's got to be one positive to that. If you keep moving laterally, creases tend to develop as the game moves on, and they can run it back inside later.
The last run got a couple. Here's second and eight. He didn't even try to signal for a timeout, so they must have not been aware of the numbers.
I think he lost track of the time left in the play clock and probably was trying to read the defense and trying to figure out which play to run and just lost track, and it cost him.
You think back to the Super Bowl against New England. The Rams never even got into the red zone in that game. And now here they are in the red zone on their opening drive with a first down.
Definitely. Let him get outside and create. And if he has to run it, he has a little bit more space.
Second and goal, and they will try again from the 2-yard line.
Man, this simulation. You can tell a nigga, this ain't, I ain't know nobody ass nigga.
They'll let Charles try and get him in. And he takes it across for a Rams touchdown.
You niggas team souped up too.
A great effort there. His third touchdown now on the year. And the Rams take it right down and score on the opening drive. Jason Myers now for the extra point. It's up, it's good, and the Rams take a 7-0 lead. After the touchdown, here's Myers to boot it away. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And he'll take it back to about the 19-yard line. Taken down at the 20 after a gain of just one.
Well, it's time for them to be good teammates right here. And what I mean by that is possess the ball for a little while. Get at least two first downs. Give their defense a chance to settle down after they give up a touchdown. Certainly look like something that they discussed all week in practice, getting ready for this one. Take the big shot right out of the gate. At worst, you'll open up the defense a little bit, loosen them up, have them back on their heels.
Hey. set up a throw. Open man is the tight end, Nick Boyle. And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line. It's an Eagles first down on a gain of 11. Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. They'll drop the throw. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Credit that sack to Dante Fowler Jr.
Joe Burrow.
They just gave up a sack there, and if I'm not mistaken, they gave up four last week, didn't they?
Yes. And yeah, just looking really porous, aren't they?
They really are, and I'm wondering if I'm going to have to start thinking about keeping the tight end in, maybe a back, someone to help assist, because right now, the quarterback's been getting hit a lot in the last couple of games.
Now Leonard Fournette. Well executed there on second down, so do you go back to the air on third?
Well, that's a possibility, but now you've opened up things to where you showed that you would run the ball in long-distance situation. You might come back again because I doubt they believe you'll do it a second time.
Out of the gun now on third down. Funches has it complete. 17 yards and a first down for Philly.
They've got good playmakers on the offensive side of the ball. I don't know what happened last week to really hurt their performance and hold down their production, but I would dare say that this week in practice, there's a lot of talk about how they're going to increase their proficiency.
And that was a good start, getting the playmakers involved. You mentioned that to me pregame. That's what they did there.
Yeah, I think a lot of people think the coaching staff really gets on them, and that's how they motivate them. Most of these guys are self-motivated. They have a lot of pride in their performance.
And he'll be taken down as that will take us to the end of the first quarter of play. After 1-7-0 on EA Sports.
Oh, got the text. That nigga Tyreek Hill hurt.
Able to get 7 on that first down pass play. 2nd and 3. Tackle's going to be made at the Rams' 15-yard line. Fournette, a first down carry. And effective running here. He'll take it down inside the 10. It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets him to 2nd and 4.
That play wasn't quite as big as the play that preceded it, but still, got to like the way they're moving the football, partner.
Absolutely. Pretty good room to run on that last play.
Yeah, they didn't get a first down, but still, you'll take runs like that each and every time, won't you?
I got to see what that is. Tyreek hit.
2nd and 4.
Shoulder tail. I got to hit that nigga in the shoulder.
Escaping the pressure.
Hurt his shoulder.
5 yards on the scramble, and that's enough to pick up the first. First and goal, and a chance to get that initial touchdown right back. Now they'll throw here out of the gun, eluding the pressure right. And this is caught. Touchdown, Philadelphia. Nick Boyle, his first touchdown here of the new campaign, as they are now on the board here in the first half. Gold able to tack on the extra point, and we are tied at 7.
Chris Collins, you have 5 weeks.
Each team's had it. Each team has scored. 7-7 here as the kick's away. This will be taken in at the 1. Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. And they had to wait a long time to get the football back. Probably not what you were hoping for when you got an offense that's humming.
Agreed. What you were looking for is the defense get the ball back pretty quickly, right? Hoping for a 3 and out. So that didn't happen. You can't yell at your D for that. They've got to take care of their own business and reestablish themselves now that they're back on the field.
Now this will leave them a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down. I think you mentioned in the opening drive that these guys needed to establish the run, protect the young QB. I actually wrote that down, believe it or not. So how would you assess things so far?
I'm kind of touched that you actually wrote something like that down. I appreciate that, partner. But I do think they've been able to do that. Maybe not as effectively as they've wanted to, but I think we'll see more of as this game goes along, because they want to continue to take care of that young QB.
Second and one. And that'll be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on, third down.
That's very well timed there defensively, because it's not a bad throw, but the collision came at the exact time he was reaching to bring in the football. Really, really well done.
Decent offense, just better defense. I think you're right. They tried the throw on second down, unsuccessful. Now it's third and one. They go with a fullback line, and he's got the first down yardage as he brings this up to the 47. An effective 7-yard third down conversion.
On third and one, it seems natural to just turn and hand it to the biggest guy you have in the backfield, but usually he's not the primary runner. So for the defense, they're often keying on the running back because he's the guy who gets the ball more often, and the fullback is the blocker. When he ends up carrying the football, that's a heck of a tendency breaker, and now you're just trying to jump on his back and hold on.
First down carry by Elliott. And running room scarce here. He's going to be stopped in his tracks at the line of scrimmage. Officially no gain on the play, and it's second down. So after the run for no gain, here's second and 10. Second and 10. Screen pass to Charles. And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 40. It's a gain of 11 and a first down, L.A.
When you run a screen pass really well, you got to like the look of it, because so many parts come together to make it work well. The offensive linemen, where they're faking people out, the back slipping out there, catching the football, then all of them going together as one unit downfield, a really nice pickup.
So from Philadelphia territory now, here's a first and 10 at the 42-yard line. Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. Oh, a scrap for the football, and he's going to come down with it. A good pickup there, 21 yards.
I know many people like to throw to the tight end, maybe in a little flexed out position, because he creates mismatches with his size. But slot receivers do the same thing with their quickness, their speed, and their route running savvy.
On the PAT, and that makes the score 14-7. And after the touchdown, here's Myers to boot it away. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. They trail a one-score deficit, 14-7, as they come up first and 10. They'll start out on the ground. It's Leonard Fournette. And he's upended after a gain of 2 out to the 27. Henry Anderson there on the stop. They'll break the huddle, come up on second and 8 at the 27-yard line. We've hit the 2-minute mark of the second quarter, 14-7. in a couple of minutes, we'll get you to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. The coach will have stats and scores from earlier today in the NFL. Here's second and eight. And he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. The sack by Robert Quinn. You never want to give up a sack. From the O-line's perspective, they hate it for several reasons, especially because they felt like they let little brother down back there in the pocket.
Oh, no doubt. They have a ton of pride, and they go into every job wanting to keep that guy clean. They want that uniform with no grass stains, no dirt, nothing on it. But it's really, really difficult. You're talking about some terrific athletes who are trying to put him on the ground.
Forced out to his left. He may try and run for this. Good coverage downfield led to him taking off, picking up the first down on a 13-yard run. The Eagles going to take the first of their timeouts as they'll get a chance to talk it over after picking up the first down. They go play action here on first down. And he's got the hook up to Moore. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. 33 yards that time. They'll try the right side here with four down.
I know we love our jobs, and pretty much any play we see, we're pretty, you know, excited about. But big plays, let's face it, that's what we absolutely live for. How about that one?
That was great. And what our camera missed was the fist pump from the sideline after that catch. They're fired out. That's a big game. A rare misstep on that last play because the drive has been strong, but now it's second and 12. Here we go on second and 12. Juju Smith-Schuster, his first touchdown of the new season, as they are an extra point away now from tying this football game. And a little time left on the clock, so on the other side, they're thinking, gosh, we'd like to get that lead right back.
Yeah, thanks for pointing that out. Here I am going ahead and tapping out the first half.
Well,
there's still time. They've got to make a decision about what they want to do on the kickoff, whether they want to let their return guy touch it.
Gold with the extra point, and we've got a tie game here in a back-and-forth first half. This one tied at 14 now as he sends this one away. This will be taken in at the one. And a pretty good return here. He'll be stopped just shy of the 25 at the 24-yard line. Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. And we're under a minute to go here. What's been an even first half, all tied up.
Yeah, still time to make something happen, too. A couple completions, you string them together, could get into field goal range. Let's see what happens.
They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. Open man is Robbie Anderson. The Rams going to go ahead and use the first of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 34 seconds to go before halftime. One play has him up past the 40 already, and another first and 10. A play fake as they set up to throw. Trying to force it to Allen, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Jerome Baker. And some room to run now. And he'll score. Touchdown, Eagles. So a dangerous pass over the middle into zone coverage, and it bit him hard.
And what's really difficult when you throw it in that direction and versus that zone, that means the linebackers have gotten to their spot, gotten their heads back around, and they can see the quarterback and everything in front of them. And they took big advantage of it, went the other direction. Excellent blocking, and picked up a touchdown.
This will be taken in at the one. And he'll get across the 20 before he's brought down at about the 23-yard line. Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. And we're under 20 seconds to go in the half. I'm guessing the wise play here is be safe.
That is the wise play, because if you think about trying to fool them here, here's what you're facing. You're facing a loosened up secondary, playing a lot deeper than normal. So even if you run some type of misdirection, you're only going to fool them for a second or so. And guess what? They're so deep, they're really not going to be out of position. Take the knee, get to the locker room.
So quickly all the way up at the 40-yard line. And an alley to run. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. Now a timeout. 7 seconds left in the first half. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. Now this time he'll look to throw. Under pressure, and he will go down. Sacked back at the 46. So we have reached halftime with a touchdown. That's the difference on the scoreboard. As we'll send you down the coast now to Orlando, that's where we find Jonathan Coachman, ready with our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach. Okay, Coach, appreciate it. A one-touchdown game here as we get set to resume play in the second half. So the Eagles with the lead, and they're going to get this football first as the third quarter gets underway. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And all that work, but he stopped where he ultimately would have been, and he simply taken a knee, and that's the 25-yard line. At the line, this Philly offense set to go. They have the lead now. They'll be looking to extend that lead.
And this is where I enjoy talking about one of my favorite subjects, tendency breakers, or counters, as I also like to call them. You've done things in a certain way in the first half, and they've had the ability to see what you've done. They're going to make their adjustments. So guess what? You adjust yourself and try and stay ahead of the pace, because you are looking for some separation in this ball game.
The adjustment to the adjustment.
Without a doubt. Show them one thing, hit them with something else.
They'll run it again with Fournette. 7 yards there and a first down.
They're trying to show that they can run the ball, protect this lead. Give it to the backs, play a little bit of keep away, don't you think?
And that's probably a good philosophy at this point, going to make that defense stand up and stop them. So from the 36 now, first and 10. This is Fournette, and an alley to run, and he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. 12 yards is the pickup, good for an Eagle first down. After a gain of only a couple.
They know that old expression, it's not my night. It hasn't been his so far. I don't know if the legs are a little bit heavy. Sometimes having to hang out all day and play doesn't exactly play to your advantage, but it's been a tough go for him.
And every time he looks up, somebody's there defensively. That was the same case on that play. From the midfield strike, they'll look to throw. Flushed out right. He's going to find his running back. It's complete. Now he'll be out just a yard or two shy of the 30. 17 yards and a first down for Philly.
Sometimes it's design, and sometimes you just have to know when to leave the pocket and move and make something happen. And on that play, he's able to get on the run and was still accurate throwing the football.
On the run, it's Fournette. Trying to run inside, but nothing there. Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be second down.
That didn't appear to be a run blitz. He just darted in once he saw the run develop. That appeared to be a case of see ball, get ball.
Officially nothing on that last run. They'll try again, second and ten. Now a handoff here to his running back. And some room to work.
Let's go, Philly.
His first touchdown here of the new campaign. And the Eagles able to push further out in front. Still plenty of time left in the game, but now starting to pull away a little bit. Get some breathing room with that one.
And damn, my controller didn't go.
NFL locker rooms are cookie cutter, that everyone's saying the exact same thing in every situation. But I do know that all 32 teams have an emphasis on starting fast. Game, you know, second half, no matter what. With his first 5 minutes, first three, whatever, this was a big score to start second half.
And what's the score, man, over there? What quarter y'all in? Well, my nigga made NFL defensive for the week.
At the line. And their halftime hole now even deeper. They need a big drive here.
Seven tackles, five sacks.
They were down at the half. Now, as you mentioned, they're down a little bit bigger. But no time for discouragement. Just got to get back to it, right? Put your shoulder against the boulder and start pushing. And try and get back to where you were to start the half. They'd love to just strike back with a touchdown right here. And if it's a long play, so be it. But the main goal, get a couple of first downs. Run some plays, run some clock. Allow their defense to get a chance to catch their breath, settle down, and relax a little bit after they just gave up a score.
Back to throw.
Got him. Come on, y'all, get this stop right here. Come on.
So how happy was he to work his way back to the quarterback and put him on the ground?
He dropped it.
A nickname after something like that, some big jelly or something like that.
Now a third down throw, but it misses the target, incomplete. You can tell they were hoping for a flag there offensively. Several on the sideline motioning. Hey, why not a penalty? What did you see?
Yeah, I think you've got to let them play, and the officials are instructed. If there's contact coming from both sides, no flag. Let them fight it out.
And forces fourth down. A good return there. Call it 13 yards. And the Eagles will have it, taking over first and 10. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. The ledger for them so far looks pretty good, doesn't it?
It certainly does. Touchdown, touchdown, touchdown. Not sure it can be much better than that. They've got to feel very good about the groove that they're in at this stage of the game.
They'll come out throwing here on first down. To the right side, and he's got more complete. And he'll be out of bounds across the 30-yard line. That throw good for four. It's second down. 4 yards on that last completion, so that sets up second and six.
Let's go, Fournette!
A big run by the big man, Fournette, 45 yards. So the big play gets him all the way down to the outskirts of the red zone here for first and 10. Now And that is incomplete.
I thought that was a pick.
He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down.
We good.
That would have been a great catch, but it's real difficult to hold on to him because it was contested all the way. Would have been a great play if he had been able to haul that one in.
Well, once again, they'll go from the 23-yard line on second and 10. Gonna give this time to the tailback. And now a fumble. The ball's out. And the Rams have got it. Going the other way. And his guys are going to take over at the 21-yard line. Often on fumbles, you look at the guy who coughed it up and say, geez, what did he do? But hey, let's tip the cap to the defense here.
Not a problem at all, my man. I'm not even going to tip it. I'm going to doff my cap to him. Congratulations. Big time play. Knocking it free and creating something good
for him. Look at the defense.
He goes down. Everson Griffin on the sack. Taken to the fourth round back in 2010. What a steal.
God damn, he would bait. Hell, you dropped that ball.
City of brotherly love, Philadelphia. It's the Rams trailing, but they do have the football as we start the fourth and final quarter. And the job becomes twice as difficult now after the sack. It's second and 20. They'll look to throw into the hands of his receiver, Anderson. A big gain there after going backwards, and that'll lead to a third down.
Man, I thought he jumped it.
Set up to throw. That one complete.
Oh, yeah.
And he gets it to the 32. Good enough for a first down.
Stupid ass.
They only get two there, but on third and one, that's all they needed to keep the drive going. From the 32 now, here's first and 10. They're going to look to throw. He's got this one complete to Perriman. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. And a nice gain of 21 yards. So from Philadelphia territory now, here's a first and 10 at the 47. They'll look to throw here. And that is incomplete. Showed off the arm strength there, but to no avail. Second down.
This defense was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it.
They've got the lead, fourth quarter. Maybe can expect more passes like that downfield. After the incomplete pass here now is second and 10. And he has another first down as he'll get the ball down to the Eagles 28.
What a catch and one-handed, and I'm starting to lose my awe.
Who's gonna pick this ball off?
And maybe I shouldn't. How much of this is the player? How much of it is the glove?
Those gloves.
Who's gonna pick this ball off and take this game?
Picked off by Malcolm Jenkins. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Defensively that time, they were in zone coverage. As a rookie QB, what lesson can you learn there?
Well, understand this. You saw zone in college, and the defensive backs reacted, but they don't react like they do on this level. So when they're in zone and they see the ball coming to them, they'll react at least a half a second faster. You've got to know where you want to go with the ball and be decisive with it. Otherwise, the end result can be something you don't like.
Second down, here's Fournette. And he'll get it up a little shy of the 15. They'll spot him down at the 14-yard line. 9 yards to pick up there, and it's a first down. Now another first and 10. timeouts. It's just their first. They'll be down to two remaining as we step aside here in the fourth quarter. Back to throw here. They'll find Smith-Schuster. That's complete. A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion. Facing a second and two after that last catch. Good for 8 yards. Second and two. Flush to his right.
Damn, huh?
He can't find anywhere to go with it, and he goes down. Now the Rams will signal for a timeout, their second. That's going to be their second. They'll be left with one more plus the two-minute warning, and we'll be back. The Eagles on third down. A perfect 3-for-3 as they look to keep that streak going. This is third down and 12. The draw. This is four down. And this play going to be stopped in its tracks at the 32, and obviously well short of the first down. They'll get six there on the run, but it brings up fourth down. Here's Brett Kern now. Always a good sign when your first punt comes in the fourth quarter. Just a single punt for him in the loss last week as he sends this one away. Taken in at the 22. We'll call that a 43-yard punt, two on the return. And we have reached the two-minute warning. Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. And there are parts of their last drive they'd like to emulate. Of course, they'd like to forget the ending. The
give me him.
Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Down under 2 minutes to go in this football game. So it's Rams football here as we get you reset. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over.
It ain't the team, it's me.
And his throw is incomplete. It was the veteran Jenkins who got a hand in there to disrupt it.
When I watched that play, I thought about what my coaches had told me in the past. The biggest teaching was locate the football so you can make a play.
Oh, shit.
That's exactly what he did there. That was nice.
The play action fake. They'll look to throw. Now a desperation.
Hell no.
Deep downfield. And that'll be incomplete. Now they took their shot all right, but it comes up empty. And it's fourth down.
And you just know when that play call came in, their eyes lit up because anytime you get a chance to get a shot downfield,
don't be surprised.
Missed an opportunity.
Shit, all right.
Gotta try it.
Don't be surprised.
Open man is Anderson, and they're gonna get this beyond the 40 before it's taken down. They keep the game alive at least for the moment as it's a first down. And they'll get this well past midfield before being stopped just before the 35. That's back-to-back plays of over 20 yards. He'll look to throw, and Anderson's got it. Chewing up big yardage, another nice gain there. This one goes for 20. Back to throw now on first down. And this is Cook with the grab. And he'll get it here to the 10-yard line. The Rams going to be forced to use their third and final timeout as the clock will stop with 34 seconds to go in the game. 6 yards was the pickup on the last completion, so here's second and four. Second and four.
Well,
and this is intercepted, and that should do it. Picked off by Jerome Baker. That's what he was hoping for, Charles. That's now three interceptions in this ball game.
But there's a lot of knowledge to be gleaned every time you throw an interception if you do things the right way. And hasn't there been a pretty darn good quarterback along the way who threw a lot of interceptions early, learned from them, and became great later?
Who would that be?
That'd be one Peyton Manning. Threw 28 his rookie year. That's the NFL record. How'd things turn out for him?
I think okay. He's the guy in all the commercials now, right?
Yeah, I think he's doing okay.
So it's a victory here for the Philadelphia Eagles. And it was their defense that really made the statement after the break. They pitched the second half shutout.
Yeah, think about the team that just got vanquished. They did score in the second quarter. Do you think they thought at all that that would be their last points of the game?
No, but what a second half. The adjustment, whatever they did in the locker room, it certainly worked.
It certainly did, and you're exactly right. Whether it was an adjustment, whether it was just more focus on what they planned to do going in, whether they just played better, whatever it was, it all came together in the second half, and no points were allowed.